Shri Ashish Baguna ji, Mr. Ajay Sharma, Chair FICCI Food Processing Committees, Mr. Hemant Malik, Dilip Shana, ladies and gentlemen. This is indeed the first interaction with the industry after the very positive budget for the food processing which the government has announced. And I'm sure all my friends in industry must be happy about it, that food processing has been getting attention, due attention of the government, which it should have been. Because the farm or farmer stress, farm level stress has become a very serious issue of concern, not only for the government but also for the industry and for everybody in the country. Because it's a farmer who produces food for all of us. The food security, nutrition security, all these issues we can talk about confidently if our production levels are good. The Indian agriculture scenario has seen tremendous dynamism over the years with regard to production. As we all know, from the very acute shortage of food in the country, we have come to the surplus food production. Now there is time for diversification, and horticulture produce has taken over the food grain production. With this changing and scenario of production and diversification also changing, the strategies and the focus areas with regard to food. Today, the issues are with regard to managing surplus, creating infrastructure and storage for the horticulture commodities which are highly imperishable nature. That actually brings food processing into focus, because unless the production is backed by the food processing infrastructure, there is no other way you can increase sample of life or can reach them to the different areas of the country or even export. Because in export also, even you export raw commodities, certain amount of processing or packaging need to be undertaken. So rightly, I think this is an appropriate time where government should focus on this sector and focus more. Fortunately, we have had a very progressive regulator over the last few years. I have seen when I came in food processing about 5 years back, the whole industry was complaining about the regulator only. They will continue to do, because always there is scope for better. So, but I think if I am not exaggerating, 90% complaints of the food industry is over with this regulator, and we hope we continue to go over here so that remaining 10% will also be to take care of. Processing, if you, I need to tell you, but if you see world over, is in a growing industry, or is making money in the countries where it has direct linkage with the production areas. The public of that country has more faith in the processed food or food product you are offering, if they are more certain about the areas where from they are coming and what type of practices are being followed. That can only happen if processing industry links its activities to the production and to the farmers and know where from their produce is coming. When we talk of quality, we talk of quality in a holistic manner. Not only there is a safe for health, but it should be nutritious also. It should be offering value for money. It should be good for health, because food has direct impact on health. But if I don't know where from my raw material is coming, what type of practices are being followed, what type of inputs are being used, I may claim it, but I don't know whether I will be sure to claim that my product is of that quality which I would like to offer to fellow countrymen. So that is why I keep requesting, the farmer has to become an integral part of the food processing. I won't hesitate naming some of the major players like ITC has been working with farmers, and that has shown in their business strategy also. Nestle, Mr. Narayan is here, has been working in the dairy sector with the farmers, Maharashtra, Punjab, and in many more areas, Haryana. Coke has come out with an Unnati product, which all of you may be knowing, where they are revolutionizing mango plantation in the country. Traditionally, we used to have about 700 trees per hectare. They are taking it to more than 2,000 trees per hectare. These things need to be repeated in almost every crop. We are faced with a scenario where we have a lot of surplus and there is a problem of managing that, but we also have a lot of import merely for processing purpose. We import 80% of pineapple concentrates. We even import apple concentrates to make apple juice, where we have plenty of pests, and C-grade apple don't even get the market rates. Surprisingly, we are having huge stocks of wheat, but we are importing more than 1 million or 2 million wheats primarily for processing purpose, red wheat. Whereas in North India, we are producing huge quantities which government had to purchase, surprisingly of very low quality. And on the other hand, we need good quality for good products in bakery and other items, we have to import. So these are the mismatch actually which we have to look into now. Why we should be producing wheat in some of part of the Haryana and Rajasthan, where we can produce barley, which is having much more commercial value nowadays. And there is a demand, the private players are looking for the expanding areas. Here we need to change our policy priorities also with regard to Ministry of Food, Agriculture is concerned, and the state government departments are concerned. I would actually like Vaguna sir to work on traceability issues now, because I think that is one area which can really motivate industry to look for the production side. And we should, because there are a lot of concerns have been raised in various forums with regard to the use of pesticides in the leafy vegetables or fruits. And there are hardly any mechanism available to measure that in fresh fruits and vegetables. This can only be checked through the practices which should be monitored by the suppliers or retailers or anybody who is playing the role of aggregator. So if we can have the rule of traceability, which I am of the opinion will come into play sooner or later, it will encourage industry to tie up with the production areas, and farmer will have to become a equal partner or player with them, and that will be the real good scenario with regard to food processing. So hopefully, I am sure some work or some thinking may be going into it, and in coming times we should see that. Industry has, food processing industry in India is still actually at a stage which we can call it's not reached to a mature level, and there are a lot of challenges with regard to credit availability. The normal financial system still puts in food processing industry at par with any other industry or any other sector and sees it more risky. And therefore, the cost of the credit becomes high because they treat it as a seasonal industry or industry having higher risk. We have been raising this issue and we have been thinking over it to ease out this situation. Government has already announced food processing as industrial activity for the purpose of priority sector lending. So at least it has come in that fold where a certain earmark lending for amount is available. But we are also thinking whether we can have sector specific financial institutions in the country which have a real appreciation of the nature of industry, the way it works, and can work with the industry and take care of the credit requirements. In this year's budget announcement, if you have seen the speech of the Honorable Finance Minister, this request of ours has been agreed to, and we would be working with industry and relevant players to come out with the programs where we can become partner in raising such institutions which can lend to the food processing sector. The issue of indigenization of the machine and technology is also actually very big. Today, for any sophisticated processing, we have to import from the outside. Almost, I think, 90% of the automated industry are coming from outside. We have huge scopes. We have traditional cuisines which can be actually upgraded, expanded for export purpose, standardized. But technology is creating a problem. And I think this is one area where I need the industry to play its role and provide input to the R&D institutions so that this area can be attended. And we can actually universalize many of our products if we standardize them and can produce them in an acceptable form which can be presented to the world. So there is a huge scope for this. Packaging is an area where industry keep facing problems because of the use of plastic or coating. Sometimes some High Court or Supreme Court or some other court keep banning use of these. I had one interaction on this issue and I was surprised to know that even there is no serious R&D on this field to develop alternate to the plastic for the packaging purpose. This is one area where I think we can work with the industry, and we have a program where we can fund R&D project also. Let's approach to the premier institutions which are in this field, where we can develop a material which is biodegradable and can take place of the plastic, which can really be very useful for the industry for the future. Because now with the environment compliance concerns, I think it's a responsibility of user for the disposal of the plastic you are using, and it has a lot of gray areas. How you will do it, what you will do it, whether Nestle is responsible for collecting every Nestle product wrapper from the country, throughout the country, or you can focus in an area basis and collect everybody's wrapper and recycle. So there are a lot of issues which are agitating industry, but I think we should, apart from taking care of what is our hand, let's think for the future and develop material which can substitute this non-biodegradable product. That actually brings us lot of role of the digitization also in the food processing. Nowadays, since alternate mode of marketing is developing, online market firms are coming up, startups are there, which are playing big role in the marketing. This is another area where we can have some program to promote digitization and big way in the food processing. And I feel this is a very appropriate time where FICCI has taken up this issue. And I'm sure today whatever suggestions would come up will set the agenda for the next 2 years to work on. Let me elaborate on some of the programs which government has been offering to the industry to take advantage of. In the budget, one new program has been announced by the finance minister, that is Operation Green. This is on the lines of Operation Flood, which everybody may be knowing with regard to the dairy industry which has developed in our country. And initially we are required to focus on the highly perishable commodities which impacts general people. And Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, in his public speech also has said that he has top priority for the farmers. And top means not the higher level, but top means tomato, onion and potato. So this Operation Green will be focusing initially on the crops of such a highly perishable nature and attend to its end-to-end logistic requirements, promoting farmers' organization, processing capacities, storage, movement issues, because these three crops have been creating lot of price fluctuation in a season in some part of the country every time. So if we can work together and create larger cluster of production, entire processing and logistics with it, I think we can offer substitute produce or products to the public when there is a scarcity of it, and we can absorb if there is a surplus of in the crop. So this is the area on which we are having interactions with the industry. One round of interaction we already had, and I think second round of interaction we are going to have on 20th, where state government will also be on the board. So here I seek input from the industry which we can use it and can really work out a program which can offer a long-term solution to this problem. We have announced last year Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana. This program provides end-to-end incentives to create infrastructure right from farm gate to the processing units to the industrial infrastructure to R&D and also the skill development and all that we need to fill up our gaps in the value chain. So, and we have received tremendous response to this program. About 5 to 6 programs are there. You know already mega food parks, which is larger industrial area. The second one is agro processing clusters, which you can call as a mini mega food park in a smaller areas to create industrial infrastructure for exclusively food processing. We have a program for integrated cold chain development throughout the country. 250 projects are already there. About out of this 112 has already been completed. We are coming up with more such projects. Then we have individual unit scheme, which is presently being restricted to the mega food parks and designated food parks, and why I will elaborate that. Then we have a program which provides incentive for setting up food testing infrastructure, which will allow you to have testing as per the food safety standards. We also have a program for R&D, Then we have a program for skill development. Those industry players who would like to go in skill development can take advantage of this and create infrastructure in their training centers if they are approved by NSDC. So the entire value chain is being covered under this program, and above that will be the Operation Green. I do feel actually we have a very restricted our program of unit to the food parts. There were objections from the industry why we are restricting it. But I do see actually a sense of indiscipline in our life, whether we are bureaucrat or industry or common man. If we see problem of Delhi today of ceiling, or we have seen it about 4-5 years back, the type of problems created, we don't seem to be actually complying with any sort of regulation in our day-to-day life, and we go for the easiest way to which we think is there. In industry also, we would like to put our industry anywhere or everywhere. But I do feel because the industry is an establishment which is designed for few years with certain type of discipline built into it and require an appropriate environment to grow. At the one hand, we keep requesting and raising issues of infrastructure, well-developed infrastructure should be there for the sector, but at the same time, when it's developed, we hesitate to use it. I do feel if food processing develops in a cluster basis, its cost can be reduced and it becomes easier for the industry to comply with the food safety standards. So there are industrial areas, there are food parks, there will be agro clusters. Having modern infrastructure with common facilities and better environment to comply with the safety standards, including testing infrastructure. So if industry can take advantage of these clusters where public money has been invested, it will perhaps be better. Your investment will be much less and more viable if the units are set up there. So that's why we have restricted to only the areas where modern infrastructure is available for the growth of the industry. Of course, these issues which cannot be we cannot pass a judgment or cannot be solved in a day. New issues keep coming, and that's why we keep meeting in such forms. I'm sure today's discussion will come out with bright ideas to work on with all the stakeholders to take our food processing sector to the next level. At the end, I would like to extend my heartiest thanks to the industry to participating wholeheartedly in World Food India. And if I go by the feedback I have received from the domestic players, from the politicians, from the state governments, or even from the governments outside the country and the food processing industry, this has been a resounding success, and it has been success because the way you participated in it and the way you presented yourself before the world. Thank you very much.